Hope you are all keeping well and enjoying the Christmas video that we're showing for you. The reading is from Luke chapter 2, verses 4 to 14. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were shepherds living out in the field nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favour rests." Thanks be to God for his word.
Today we hear Far away in Bethlehem, a baby boy was born, born with neither riches nor with fame. Yet wise men came from all around to bring him their gifts, and peace was felt by all who heard his name. Angels watched as he slept and gently rocked his bed, their voices singing softly in his ear. His mother and his father both gave thanks to God above for the greatest gift of all, their son so dear. They knew his life upon this earth would not be filled with wealth. They also knew he would encounter strife. But most of all, they knew that he would be a loving child and teach the love of God throughout his life. At Christmas, we celebrate this birth of Jesus Christ. Let's keep in mind the truth of Christmas Day. For it's not the Christmas wrappings nor the gifts that lie within, but our gift of love to others in every way.
That mourns in lonely exile here, until the Son of God appears. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee. O Israel, O come, O Son of God Most High, deliver us from sinfulness and pride, restore in us a childlike to consecrate and set us apart. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, O Savior of this world, the long-awaited promise you foretold, and right the wrongs that man hath done. We pray your glorious kingdom come. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. Let us close in prayer. In a world where worry, not peace, prevails, stir up that good news again. This Christmas, make it real in our hearts. Never have we needed your joy and peace more than now. Thank you for the gift of Jesus, our Emmanuel, the Word made flesh. Forgive us for forgetting that your love never changes, never fades, and that you never abandon the purpose for which you came, to save us from our sinful condition and to give us life eternal, the joy of the relationship with a holy God. Your birth and your death sealed your promise to us forever. God grant you the light of Christmas, which is faith, the warmth of Christmas, which is purity, the righteousness of Christmas, which is justice, and the belief in Christmas, which is truth, the all of Christmas, which is Christ. And now, may the blessing of joy abide within you. May the blessing of peace rest upon you. May the blessing of love flow through you. And may the blessing of the Lord be yours at Christmas and in the new year. Amen.